In this NLP playlist, we have covered the text representation techniques from label encoding to TF-IDF. Today, we are going to talk about word embeddings. There are certain limitations of bag of words and TF-IDF, which we have discussed in previous videos, which is the vector size can really be big for bag of words and TF-IDF model. And it may consume a lot of compute resources, memory, and so on. Let's say you have vocabulary of 200,000 words or 100,000 words. Each vector for each of the documents would be 100,000 size. And that may be too much. And the presentation is sparse, meaning in that vector, most of the values are zero. So it is not a very efficient presentation. The other problem we saw was that, let's say you have two words, I need help, I need assistance. These are similar sentences. You expect that their vector representation should be similar. But since these are TF-IDF and bag of words are count-based methods, the vector representation might not be similar. Here you can see, there is one here, zero here, one here, zero here. So these techniques do not capture the meaning of the words properly. You expect that if you have two sentences which are similar, their vector should be very similar. Word embedding tries to address both of these shortcomings. First, similar words will have similar vectors, similar words or even sentences. For example, good and great, these are two similar words. When you will use word embedding, you will notice that their vector will be very similar. See, 3.1, 3.1, 4.4, 4.2, there will be slight differences, but mostly they will be similar. They will also be lower in dimension, which means the size of this vector will be 300. 300 is one of the popular vector sizes in word embeddings. It could be 50 size, 100 size, etc. But it won't be like 100,000 because your vocabulary size is 100,000. And these representations are dense representation, meaning you won't notice too many zeros as opposed to the previous techniques where most of the values in the vectors were zero. Now, there are various word embedding techniques such as Word2Vec, Glow, fastText. These are the techniques which are built on different approaches. And the common technique that we use to build these word embedding, which is Word2Vec, Glow, and fastText, is using continuous bag of words and skip gram. Now, this might be a jargon, so just hold on. I will go over that in detail a little later. Then there are techniques such as BERT and GPT, which are transformer-based embedding techniques. These are the latest advancements in NLP. When you do Google search, it is using BERT. So you might have heard all these jargons. So I'm just going to go over these jargons in brief, and in the later videos, we'll go over them one by one. So don't worry if you're confused right now, just don't worry. Just remember that these are various word embedding techniques. There is a technique called ElMo, which is based on LSTM. Now, what do these techniques do? See, they convert a word or a sentence into a vector representation so that it can capture the meaning of that word properly. Not only that, you can do arithmetic with the words. Word2Vec has this famous example that you can do arithmetic. You know how you do arithmetic with numbers? Let's say 2 plus 3 is equal to 5 minus 1 is equal to 4. You can do similar things with the text, and that's mind-boggling, right? See, king has all these attributes. Authority, king is rich, it has power. But if you remove the element of man from that and add woman, it becomes queen, correct? Queen also has power, authority, lot of money, but the gender is different. So you subtract that gender, add a new gender, now you get queen. We'll look all of this in detail. We'll look into this in the detail during the code. But for Word2Vec, I have already made a different video. So if you go to YouTube, search for Code Basics Word2Vec, that first video that you see, which is part of my deep learning playlist, please watch that, because that will give you a very good understanding of the actual method or actual technique behind Word2Vec. Since I already have that video, I'm not going to repeat the same thing here. I would highly recommend you watch that. Okay. If you don't watch it, you're going to probably miss few things in this NLP series. So word to vec, very, very important concept. You need to watch that video. Now, there are variations based on the data set that they are trained on. For example, word to vec, you can train on Google News data set or some different corpus. And based on that, you can get different variations. So word to vec is like a technique, but you can use that technique on different data set. It's like you are training support vector machine. So support vector machine is one technique, but you can train it on Amazon reviews or movie classification. Similarly, word to vec, the actual embedding vector, you can get by training it in a different corpus. Same like Glow. If you train it on Twitter, let's say there is a Glow Twitter 50, this model, which is available in GenSim library, it will understand the tweets better, all the slang and all the short form that you use. It will understand that better. And then there could be a wiki, GigaWord, Glow version. There are so many different models, but the basic techniques are Glow, Word2Vec, fastText, and so on. Similarly, the transformer based models such as BERT, also based on what type of data set they're trained on, you can get BioBERT or FinBERT. FinBERT is trained on financial data set. BioBERT is trained on biomedical database. And you can also do some parameter tuning in BERT and get things like Albert or Roberta. So you would hear all these jargons, you know, FinBERT, Albert, Roberta, Word2Vec. So I'm just throwing all the jargon so that you get some overview. Don't worry if you don't understand these techniques. We'll go over them in detail in the later video. But just to summarize what these techniques produces, see folks, it's very simple. The whole purpose of these techniques is to convert word into a vector, because we have seen previously, machine learning models don't understand text. They need numbers. So you can convert a single word such as good to a vector. You can convert entire sentence to a vector, and that is called sentence embedding. Or you can convert the entire paragraph or a news article or a document into a vector. So in the future video, we will be writing code and we'll be using these techniques to solve the actual NLP problems. This was just a short introduction on word embedding. Once again, watch my Word2Vec video, and by the time you come to the next video, you should have watched that video. Okay, this video, the first one. Otherwise, you're going to miss out on few things. All right, if you like this playlist, give it a thumbs up and share it with your friends. Thank you.